Hi friends, today we are going to see about some important formulas and equation from the electricity. The first one is electric current. Electric current I is defined as charge per time, that is Q by T. Charge is measured in coulomb and the time is in second. Then current, the unit of current I is ampere. Okay. Next one, drift velocity. Drift velocity is defined as the velocity with which free electrons get drifted towards the positive terminal when an electric field is applied. So we can write the drift velocity Vd equal to mu e. Here mu e is called the mobility. So mobility is defined as the drift velocity acute per unit electric field, that is mu equal to e tau by m. Then next one is current density. Current density is defined as the quantity of charge passing per unit time through per unit area. That is J equal to Q by T by A. Q by T is nothing but it is a current. So I by A. Current density is a vector quantity. The unit of current density is ampere meter minus 2 or ampere per meter squared. Okay. Next one, relation between current density and drift velocity. J, current density J equal to N E V D. Next one, Ohm's law. Ohm's law state that the current I is proportional to V, or we can write I equal to 1 by R. From this, V equal to, that is voltage V equal to I R, or we can write resistance value R equal to V by I. Okay. Next one, electrical resistivity rho. So electrical resistivity of a material is defined as the resistance offered to current flow by a conduction of unit length having unit area of cross section. So we can write R equal to rho L by A. Here rho is called the electrical resistivity. The unit of electrical resistivity is ohm meter. Okay, next one, electrical conductivity. So electrical conductivity means it is a reciprocal of electrical resistivity. So electrical conductivity sigma equal to 1 by rho. The unit of sigma is, that is electrical conductivity is mho, meter minus 1. Mho is the reciprocal of ohm. Okay, so unit is mho meter minus 1. Okay. Next one, resistors in parallel. When we connect the resistor in parallel, we use the formula 1 by Rp equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. But when we connect all the resistor in series, we use the formula Rs equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, next one, internal resistance. Internal resistance R equal to E minus V by V into R. Next one, temperature dependence of resistance. That is RT equal to R0 1 plus alpha T. Here R0 is the resistance of a conductor at 0 degree Celsius. And RT is the resistance of the same conductor at T degree Celsius. Okay. So alpha is called the temperature coefficient. Some metals have positive temperature coefficient, that is positive value of alpha. That means resistance. The resistance increases with increasing temperature. Insulators and semiconductors have negative temperature coefficient, but metals have positive temperature coefficient, and insulator and semiconductors have negative temperature coefficient. In insulator and semiconductor, the resistance decreases with increasing temperature. Okay, so next one, thermistor. Thermistor means negative temperature coefficient material. That is, a material with a negative temperature coefficient is called the thermistor. Next one is potentiometer. Potentiometer is used to compare the EMF of the two cells. Okay, so EMF of the cell can be calculated by E2 equal to E1 L2 by L1. Okay, so if one value of EMF of the cell we can know, we find the other cell EMF. Okay, so use the formula E2 equal to E1 L2 by L1. Next one, the condition for Wheatstone bridge balance is Wheatstone bridge is the application of Kirchhoff law, and the condition for bridge balance is P by Q equal to R by S. Okay, so the next one is electric power. So electric power is I squared R. The unit of electric power is joule, but in practical use we use the formula watt hour. 1 kilowatt hour can be written as 1000 watt, that is 1000 into 3600 joules, or we can write 36 into 10 to the power 5 joules. Watt meter is the instrument used to measure the electrical power. Okay, next one, thermoemf of any thermocouple has the temperature dependence given by the relation that is voltage V equal to alpha theta plus 1 by 2 beta theta squared. Okay, so next one is the relation between theta n theta c, that is theta I. Theta n is the neutral temperature, theta c is the cold temperature. Okay, then theta is the temperature inversion. Okay, so theta n equal to theta c plus theta I by 2. Next one, Biot-savart law. So Biot-savart law means that is TP, that is magnetic field, is proportional to IdL sine theta by R squared, or we can write TB equal to KLdL sine squared by R squared. Here K is the proportionality constant and the value is K equal to mu by 4 pi. Okay, so the unit of magnetic induction is Tesla or Weber meter minus 2. Next one, current in tangent galvanometer. I equal to K tan theta. Here K values can be written as K equal to 2A BH by mu naught N. Next one is magnetic Lorentz force. This that is F equal to Q V into B plus E. This equation shows in the presence of electric field E and the magnetic field B, the total force on a moving charge. Okay. Next one, period of rotation in cyclotron. Cyclotron is used to accelerate the particle to high energies. Okay, so that is T equal to time period is T equal to 2 pi m by p cube. Then frequency F equal to reciprocal of time period T. Okay, so frequency F equal to p cube by 2 pi m. Okay, next one, current in moving coil galvanometer. I equal to K theta. Here I is proportional to theta. Okay, so K is the proportionality constant. The value of K is K equal to C by N B A. Okay, next one, current sensitivity of your voltmeter galvanometer, that is theta by I equal to N B A by C. Then voltage sensitivity of a galvanometer is theta by V equal to theta by Ig. I is the current and G is the resistance, galvanometer resistance. Okay, so we can write NBA by CG. Next one, Bohr magneton. Bohr magneton value is EH by 4 by M. Its value is 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter squared. Okay, next one, magnetic flux. That is magnetic flux pi linked with a surface held in a magnetic field B is defined as the number of magnetic lines of force crossing the closed area. That is pi, magnetic flux pi equal to BA cos theta. Next one, Faraday's second law. Faraday's second law state that is ES. E is proportional to T by dt. That is EMF, induced EMF is proportional to rate of change of flux, that is T by dt. Okay, next one, magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron, that is mu L, that is magnetic dipole moment is equal to E by 2 m L. Okay, so the next one is important one, that is gyromagnetic ratio, that is mu L by L equal to E by 2 m. Its value is 8.8 into 10 to the power 10 c kg minus 1. Okay. Next one, Lenz's law. Lenz's law is in the induced EMF E equal to minus T N by dt. Here minus sign represent the induced EMF opposed the flux. Okay. So the next one, self-inductance of a long solenoid. That is self-inductance is represented in the letter L. So L equal to mu N squared A by I. A is the number of coils, then A is, N is the number of coil, A is the area. Okay, so next one, energy stored in an inductor is, that is 1 by 2 L I naught squared. Next one, transformer ratio. K, we can write the transformer ratio K equal to ES by EP. Okay, and that is voltage. Voltage in the secondary then by voltage in the primary is equal to NS by NP. That is number of turns in turns in the secondary coil by number of turns in the primary coil equal to IP by IS. That is current in the primary by current in the secondary coil. Okay, that is the transformer ratio. Next one, efficiency of a transformer. That is efficiency is represented in the letter eta. So eta equal to ESIS by EP by IP. That is output power by input power. Next one is RMS value of current and voltage in an AC circuit. The RMS value of current can be written as I naught by root 2. Here 1 by root 2, that is value is 0.707 I naught. That is the peak value of current. Okay. So the VRMS value is E naught by root 2. Next one, inductive reactance. That is XL equal to omega L. Omega value is 2 pi F. So 2 pi F L. Like capacitative reactance value is XC equal to 1 by omega C equal to 1 by 2 by F C. Then impedance of LCR circuit. So impedance can be written as V by I. That is voltage by current is equal to Z. That is impedance. We calculate the impedance of the LCR circuit is root of R squared plus XL minus XC whole squared. Okay. So the unit of impedance is the ohm. Okay. Next one, average power in AC circuit. That is E naught by root 2 in dot I naught by root 2 cos pi. Okay. Or we can write E naught I naught by 2 cos pi. Okay, so E naught by root 2 is nothing but it is RMS value of voltage, that is ERMS. Then I naught by root 2 is IRMS. So ERMS I dot IRMS cos pi. Here ERMS dot IRMS is called the apparent power. Then cos pi is the power factor. Okay, so the next one is Q factor. Q factor is written as 1 by R into root of L by C. Okay, so that's all friends. Thank you.